All right, hello and welcome to another episode of the Manchester United Career Mode. I've had to start this on the main menu of FIFA because it keeps crashing the stream whenever I try and do it through Career Mode. So we're going to do that and obviously load into Career Mode now. But hello and welcome to Season 1, Episode 16. We've got the Manchester Derby here at Old Trafford. But beforehand, I just wanted to say a couple of things. First of all, I don't know what's up with Twitch and with any video game you try to stream directly off the Xbox, it seems to be messing up a lot. So I know it's not going to affect anyone on the YouTube kind of side of things. If you're watching on Twitch and I stop streaming and start streaming and stop streaming and start streaming, it's because the game keeps crashing. I try to reset it and try to redo it. But also for YouTube, if you see a little idle screen at the start of the video, that is because I'm trying to get the game to actually work to stream. So there's a warning for you as well. The usual apply as well. It might lag because the weather is awful. It's actually genuinely pouring it down today. And of course, audio issues are always on the horizon because Twitch don't know how to fix their shit. So, that get out of the way, we've got the Manchester Derby. We're not coming in with the best kind of form. We did beat Young Boys 3-0 in the previous episode, which is good. It kind of, more or less, if that's actually completely secured, our qualification to round of 16 of the Champions League. But in terms of the Premier League, we've been dropping off a bit. In October alone, we had 3 points out of 12 games. We've fallen down the table a bit. 3-3 draw against Everton, 2-2 draw against Leicester, 2-1 loss against Liverpool, and a 1-1 draw against Spurs. Not great results heading into this Manchester Derby, but I'll show you what the table is looking like right now. So this is what we're dealing with currently. Wolves getting a bit clear at the top now. Arsenal in second, Villa in third, and City in fourth. So if we beat Manchester City, there is a possibility we could leapfrog City into fourth. We'll definitely leapfrog Villa because they've already played their 11th, and we could leapfrog Arsenal dependent on goal difference as well. But Spurs may mess that up for us because they could also win their game and keep top four. They're playing against Everton though. So let's see what we can do in this one. Before we go into any further, words are difficult. Press conference.
Thank you for joining us. We'll start the questions now.
In a great run. You look like you got a real chance to qualify for the Champions League. I really hope we can get top four. I don't think we'll win the title this season. We'll need everybody ready, especially with the fullback crisis that we seem to have, especially the right-hand side anyway. Dalot and Wan-Bissaka out for pretty much the season. Which is either Telles or Laird. We're going to play that right-back role, just kind of switch the three fullbacks around that we do have. The other Manchester worried. We were excellent against Young Boys, but that is Young Boys. Manchester City are a different kettle of fish. We lost them in the Carabao Cup. And if I'm being real with you, I'm not feeling confident. The recent run of form, we haven't won since September in the Premier League. And we need to try and find a way to do something to get back into that top four race. We're still very much in it, actually, to be fair. We're all on the same points, fourth to sixth. We're not even out of it. It's just, we don't want to lose what momentum we had. We started off the season wonderfully, amazingly, so to speak. And ever since then, we've kind of been falling off. October was a tough month, and we've gone from 5 wins, 1 draw, and 0 losses to 5 wins, 4 draws, and 1 loss. So you can tell it's been a bit of a decline. But that doesn't mean we're out of it by any means. Like I said, look at the table. Fourth place is very much up for grabs. Take a look at the news stories then before we progress here. Manchester United keep clean sheet against Young Boys. A solid display from Manchester United's defence saw Amitai's men keep a clean sheet against BSC Young Boys and claim a 3-0 victory. They were quite easy, to be honest, but that's not a point. Trincao getting a hat-trick for Wolves. Wolves are popping off at the moment. And Man City take on Man United. De Bruyne. Ronaldo. It's a battle between two of the clubs in the pursuing pack as Manchester United host Manchester City in the league. The 3 points look vital to both teams as they attempt to close the gaps on the teams above them at the top of the table. Manchester United know that only a win will do for them as they play catch-up. Meanwhile, Manchester City know that a point wouldn't be a bad result, but they'll be chasing victory nonetheless. We should see a positive, open game of football. And for the Premier League Player of the Month October award, We had Calvert-Lewin for Arsenal, Salah for Liverpool, Ronaldo for Manchester United, and then Zaha for Crystal Palace. And they've only gone and given it to bloody Mo Salah, haven't they? Salah's impressive performances for Liverpool earned him the Premier League Player of the Month award for October. And, of course, the rivalry between Manchester United and Manchester City is set to continue this week when the teams meet again in another intriguing Premier League encounter. This is exactly the same spiel they had for the Spurs game. I'm not reading it again. But anyway, you get the point. It's a big game. It's going to be match day of the week, if that makes any sense. I don't know what team I'm going to try and go with for this one. Varane's quite tired, but I will still start him. They're going strong. I was about to say no Haaland, but they haven't signed him in this career mode. Don has been a performer this career mode, so bring him in. We're actually going to have Telles and Shaw on. Laird, I can't risk in this big of a game. Varane and Maguire. Fred in a CDM role. In fact, actually, we're going to put McTominay there. He was very good against young boys. We'll give him another run out. Fernandez, Rashford, Sancho, Ronaldo. I think that's what we roll with. Hopefully, it does the trick. We do need the 3 points desperately, but it is Man City, so I'm not fully confident, but anything's possible, all right? So we've got De Gea in goal, Shaw and Telles as a fullbacks, Varane and Maguire as a centre-backs, McTominay, CDM, Fernandes, left centre-mid, Van der Beek, right centre-mid, Sancho and Rashford, the wingers, and up front we've got the captain, Cristiano Ronaldo. Hopefully he can lead us to victory here with some crucial goals. He's lost his scorers. He's lost his spot as top scorers. Danny Ings is now on 8 goals for Aston Villa, who they're overperforming in their own right. For Manchester City, they've got Ederson in goal, Cancelo and Walker as a fullback, Stones and Diaz as a centre backs, Rodri, CDM, Bernardo Silva and De Bruyne, who of course De Bruyne is the captain. They'll be the centre mids. Mahrez left wing, Jesus right wing, and then Phil Foden in that false 9 role. So let's see what we can do, if anything. We are at Old Trafford, though. So anything's possible. I'll happily take a point if that's what I can get. I would like 3, obviously, but if I can only get 1, I'll happily take 1. The way we're playing at the moment, I'll be happy to take 1. And then who do we play next? I can't remember who we play next. But that'll be for tomorrow's double upload, anyway. And then we've got Atalanta or Villarreal. I know we've got a Champions League match. The second of tomorrow's double upload. But I just can't remember who we've got for the first of tomorrow's double upload.
It is a derby that really has taken on added significance in the last few years as the noisy neighbours.
I'm keeping with the schedule so far, but it's probably going to break at some point.
We'll have all the action live from Old Trafford as Manchester United face Manchester City.
Well, I should get some more water beforehand, but I can always go get some after this.
Welcome to Manchester, a cracking derby in prospect, and everyone on tenterhooks here at Old Trafford. It is United versus City. Derek Ray in the commentary position, joined as always by Stuart Robson. And Stuart, this should be thoroughly appetizing.
Well, Derek, what more could you ask for? A noisy stadium, two very good teams, and a massive rivalry. This should be an absolute classic.
Well, Manchester United have chosen this particular shape. David De Gea begins in goal. Harry Maguire plays alongside Rafael Varane in central defence. And the focal point in attack today is Cristiano Ronaldo. Introducing the starting players for Manchester City. Ederson between the posts. João Cancelo starts with Kyle Walker as fullbacks. Kevin De Bruyne plays with Rodri in central midfield. And rather than use a strike partnership, they've gone with just the one player in attack.
Quite honestly, I won't be surprised if we do fail to get a win here. But I would like to, obviously, because there are local rivals. We do have a right-back crisis where we're genuinely playing a left-back at right-back. It's not the end of the world, I suppose. We do have... We could bring... what's his name? Williams off of loan again. Bring him back to the club, but I don't really want to drag everyone off loan just because of having injuries. Scott McTominay. Some of these players need the loan spells. Thought we'd go for it to Bruno there. Well, I didn't think it would go to Bruno, but that was the plan anyway. Maguire stops folding in his tracks. Donny.
Rashford
on here. Get closed down. He options. Van der Beek. Ronaldo. McTominay. Sancho. His club. But he got a goal against Young Boys. A very nice goal as well. Just dribbling through the whole defence. But if he gets a goal against City here, cult hero status. Donny. Oh, it wasn't Donny. It was McTominay. McTominay a bit too far forward for my liking, but. Gabriel Jesus on the right hand side here from Man City. Good tackle by Luke Shaw. Let's try to get the ball away from City, because if they get the ball, they're just going to go, and I don't need them to do that. Then again, Donny. Oh, he wins back though. Wolves top. Incredible, to be honest. They won't stay there, I don't think, but it's incredible that they're up there. Ronaldo. Oh, tried to pick out Rashford, man. Man City read it. Maybe we should have just taken it on with Cristiano. But I didn't, so what's that? Oh no. Phil Foden's just scored an absolute worldie. I can't even lie, that's a goal of the season contender. I can't even get mad at it. There's nothing I could have done there. That's just insanity.
Well, let's take this again. The vision to play this through was superb. And when he gets onto it, he decides to go
for power. It's a really emphatic. I believe it's between Foden and Rodri. And Foden has just shot that with all he can. And he's given David De Gea absolutely no chance. Look at that. That's even as an opponent, that looks satisfying as fuck. That might be goal of the season. Phil Foden gets his third goal. And we're down. It might be a couple of years yet before we can hang on the level of Manchester City and Liverpool again. But that's what we're working towards. Give ourselves a task of not... It's not fucking who I'm in for. Give ourselves a task of not signing anyone in the first season to try and make it a bit more of a challenge. Varane stops from getting it to Foden for a second time. But this challenge is... I thought it was going to be alright because we had such a brilliant start to the season, but it's fallen apart before my very eyes. Can I go one of my centre-backs, please? No? Alright, don't worry. Nah, it's alright. I didn't want to control either of them anyway, you know? I didn't want to be a centre-back. I just wanted to let them run through, you know? This is going to be a difficult one to take. Bernardo Silva doubles the lead for the away team.
It was a good finish, but the keeper at his near post has to do a lot better. He's got to have that near post covered for me.
I would have liked to control the centre back, but De Gea does have to be doing better there. He's let out for his bloody legs, man. In contrast to the first goal is really good, and I couldn't argue about it. That one, I've got a few arguments about. I couldn't get a hold of either of my centre backs for whatever reason. And then De Gea should be down at his near post. I tried to bring him out. Should be down at his near post, saving that. First goal of the season for Bernardo Silva, which is kind of disappointing if you're Bernardo Silva. But it's against Man United, so you're probably happy. And we might actually get cricket scored here, I'm not going to lie. Beautiful pass. I'm playing us off the park. I reckon if we don't get top four, we'll probably get sacked, you know. I'm doing a lot of the other brand objectives. I can't do a lot of the other brand objectives. Expect us to stay undefeated at Old Trafford for 10 games. De Bruyne almost making it 3 from range. I wouldn't have been surprised if I had nestled in top corner. It is Kevin De Bruyne after all. There's a reason I was not confident going at this one, and it is shown inside these first 25 minutes. City have been all over us. We can't seem to break through. We can't seem to get a shot off. That being said, Man City do have definitely have a better team than we do. But that's going to change in the coming seasons. Sancho's been fouled there. Turned Kyle Walker there, but of course he was cut down in his prime. And we've got a chance here. A decent opportunity. Jadon Sancho. Could either deliver this or play it off. I don't know how this is going to work, but I'm going to deliver it in. Free kicks always are always quite weird on this. It just didn't go. Like, I've aimed it to go up, and it just didn't go anywhere. Like, I should have just passed it.
And he did well to cut
Van der Beek wins that one out. He's been a surprise package so far this season. He's been a bit quiet as of late, but.
Van der Beek. On to Bruno Fernandes.
Bruno, it's blocked. Sancho. Try to just get some space for a shot, man, but they just keep closing me down. Maguire. Oh, you've got to be joking. Okay, that's good. I should Maguire redeemed yourself. Oh, McTominay's been caught by Rodri.
Well, there you can see City haven't been able to control possession, but that won't bother them because when
they've a lot more of the ball, but they've been more counter-attacking with it, and it's worked for them.
It's been a great counter-attacking display.
Oh, fuck off, man. I just know that that's going to go in because De Gea is an absolute knob. This is a humbling experience, if anything else. Oh, my God. We've got to play a right back, or a left back, a right back. And De Gea is jumping out of the way of saves. De Gea is playing dodgeball today. That's two. That De Gea could have quite easily saved. But two. They've ended up being goals for City with 3-0 down before half time, lads. I don't really know what to tell you. This is a problem. Don't get me wrong, I didn't expect to win this. I maybe didn't even expect to get a point. Oh, fuck off, Bruno. Oh, my God. There'll just be stat panned eventually, man. Get it away. Thank fuck for De Gea actually turning up for one of the saves.
Well, I still can't believe that didn't go in, Derek. It's a fantastic stop.
Sancho move, man. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Sancho just doesn't want to make the run. I know that. Oh, my God. Where is Telles? Bro, where is Telles? I understand that they're 4-0 up and I'm getting absolutely smacked up here. Where is my right back? I know he's not officially my right back. I just want to get a bird's eye view on this. How do I... Alright. Is that Telles there? That's Telles there. Behind Bruno. Or not behind Bruno. Behind fucking Luke Shaw. Is it? Wait, hold on. I'm confused. Where? I only had three at the back there. And I actually didn't have three because Donny was the one trying to run back and stop this. Of course, it's a rebound goal as well. Is that Gabriel Jesus making it the fourth? Yep, lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. We're getting humbled to fuck here. Not really a lot I can do about it when two of my defenders have gone AWOL. I was tempted just to slide through him to fuck with Van der Beek, but they're all over us. They're dominating us here. This is not an episode that I'm a fan of. Fuck's sake. Foden scores a goal of the season contender, and every goal since then has been shite, quite frankly. You got Bernardo Silva's at the near post that could have quite easily been stopped. Mahrez is that De Gea avoided, and then that one that's just a rebound goal. I don't really know what this game wants me to do. I can't break through. I've got fucking people breeding on me, like loads of Man City players trying to stop me. We haven't really been able to do anything. Ronaldo. Are you able to do something here? Oh, it's just too much to do. Oh, come on.
Oh, he's missed an open goal. What on earth happened there?
And I'm not sure how he's missed that. That's a really bad miss.
I can tell you how he's missed that. Fucking Ederson's caught his leg, mate. Where's the penalty? Probably isn't a penalty, but just give me something, man. I'll accept a couple of goals, but 4-0 can fuck off, quite frankly.
And the electronic board has been held aloft.
It's just shite. This is just a real life Man United coming at the fucking four.
Oh, that's a really
I can't turn Mahrez. Just try to get a pass up the pitch. This has been absolutely disastrous from start to finish, and the sooner we get this game done, the sooner we can move on. Oh, Rashi. If I press the pass button, do I want you to do the ball, mate? That's right, pass. Oh, yep, okay. Bounce just didn't favour us there. Lovely, lovely. That's probably the five, isn't it? Thank you, Maguire. I mean, I don't know what I'm saying thank you for. Everyone's been shit. 4-0 at half-time, man. The game's already over. Man City have run rampant over us. I can't say they don't deserve it because they do. I think we've had one chance. It was like Ronaldo won. We've been awful. I'm devastated, man.
He's been excellent.
I thought, oh, we might be more ready to take on our fucking rivals this time around. Foden, Bernardo Silva, Riyad Mahrez, and Gabriel Jesus with the goals. I thought we'd be more ready for them since we lost in the Carabao Cup. I thought, oh, we might try a bit harder in the Premier League. We might put a bit more effort in. I don't want to tell you, day has been absolutely shite. I can't get a hold of my defenders. Some of them are just not even there. It's just been ridiculous from start to finish. 62 to 38, that's the only stat we really have in our favour in terms of possession. 8 shots to 5, 3.1 expected goals to 1.9. They've been dominant and in terms of creating chances, and they deserve the lead, and I'm quite frankly devastated. We may be able to pull off the greatest comeback of all time, perhaps. I don't know, but I don't see it. I'd like a couple of goals, though, just to make it look respectable if we are going to get fucking battered.
Kevin De Bruyne.
City have absolutely outclassed us here, and they deserve the lead, but at the same time, I feel like I can't get hold of any of my players to get the ball ever. I think it was a third goal where Tellez wasn't there. I wanted to maybe it wasn't that one. I don't know. There's been too many goals to try and keep track of. Either way, the point is, I want to use my defenders, and when I can't, it kind of fucks me. You know, like I'll try to defend with my defenders, and it doesn't defend with anyone. Brand's there. I'm just trying to clear that straight away. But Foden's fuck off. Move out the bloody way, man. If that led to a goal, I'll probably just jump to result. I mean, I probably should anyway. But oh, we are in the mud. We're in the fucking mud. And it gets me thinking. Oh, if we beat City, we leapfrog them. Yeah, not a shot in a fucking galaxy far, far away. Are we beating Man City at the moment? This team is ropes at best. Especially with an outright right back doesn't seem to be on the cards. We haven't got a starter right back. We haven't got a backup right back. Foden's making awful tackles. So we can't even move the play forward anyway. Oh, just fuck off. I'm trying to play the pass off before I get tackled, and it just seems to delay or something. I don't know. I was about to say, I wonder if Lindelof would be better than Maguire, but I think Maguire's actually been the better centre back today, so. Well, I don't think it would have mattered. De Gea, please grab that, thank you. In truth, it wasn't. No, I genuinely don't think it would have mattered. Oh, I'm passing it off, not making a touch. Game, thanks for not registering that, though. Tellez has been awful at right back. Maybe we try Luke Shaw at right back next game. Can they hit on the break? Well, Sancho's on right. He is. He's just taking the touch like an absolute idiot, though. I'm sorry for trying it at this point. And space to cross it. Bruno, Sancho, McTominay. Gets in the way once more. It's blocked by Rodri straight into the arms of Edison. I think it's just damage limitation at this point for Manchester United, isn't it? Rashford needs to try and get something on that. Nope. It's bounced over Maguire. Oh my god. Thank fuck for his strength. Thank fuck for his strength. That looked like real life Maguire then, struggling. Can I? No? Okay, I didn't want to pass it anyway, Van de Beek. I just want to keep running into trouble. Yeah.
Gabriel Jesus.
How did you know their game? How did you know exactly what to do? Alright, De Bruyne. De Bruyne's just showing off now because he knows his team have fucking won this shit.
Gabriel Jesus. Putting his body on the line.
Good block. Maguire's been one of the better players today, which is saying something because he's a defender and he's let four through. But one of the better players today. I'm considering maybe just, I don't know, moving Luke Shaw to right back next game. I think that's probably going to be a guarantee because I don't know what's up with Tellez. I mean, I do. He's just, I don't like, I don't rate him in real life. I just don't like him in general. Ronaldo. Oh, just give me it, ref, man. We're already 4-0 down. Right, let's try and fucking, there's no point. I'm just doing this for fitness reasons now. Genuinely, I'm just doing it to keep the fitness in the squad. Varane can have a rest. In fact, actually, we've got a 13-day break, don't we? I think it's Watford next now, come to memory, but. Alanga come on for Sancho. Fred could come on in here. I'm trying to. And it doesn't really matter, but Varane's going to come off for Lindelof. Just for fitness reasons, purely. It doesn't really matter. We're going to probably concede another one at least before we end this off. It's been a disaster from start to finish, and I don't want to talk about it. They've wrapped up in the first half. Grealish coming on. I didn't see who went off for City, but. I mean, it's just disappointing, really. I thought his team would come along a little bit. And then, oh, yeah, that happens. Yeah, cool. Telles and Maguire run into each other. We're getting some audio issues now. Just, you know, make it even better. Let's go. Quarter anyway, to say. I'm going to go short. I want to get Van der Beek.
And taken short.
I want to control Van der Beek to come get this, but for some reason Lindelof's also gone there.
Stones. He's in with a chance.
Good save to Gea. We're under the cosh here, and by under the cosh I mean I want to die.
What a good save that is.
I just want to get this episode wrapped up and move on to the next one as quick as possible. This has been an actual disaster. And look, they're already running short. Because I've got a bird's eye view for whatever reason. I can't see what player I want. Nice, Donny. Throw in, I think. He's been another one that's probably been one of the best today. Donny van der Beek. If you could pick a best team out of a bad lineup. Ronaldo. Can't get anything going. Bruno's taking a heavy touch for no reason. I want to try and get a counter-attack going. It just doesn't even like be on at all. Nothing seems to be on for us in this game. We just had nothing in this game. Mahrez. Knock it to Lindelof. It's going to drop to De Gea. I want to just boot it to Lindelof, but apparently it's not in the game's files for me to do that. Luke Shaw. Grealish chasing. It's just been absolutely wank today, ladies and gentlemen. I apologise profusely. Oh, we've been absolutely wank. But City have been very good as well. Can we get one back? No, because everything. Did I not get fouled in the build up to that then? Because I swear I took, like, move my leg back to take a shot on. And I just end up fucking, like, flipping on myself. Where is the defence? Where is the defence? These are not the custom tactics I put on. These are not the custom fucking tactics I fucking put on! I didn't say, let's all 11 of us run up the pitch when fucking we have one sniffing of an attack. Everyone's nowhere. Well, let's look at the only person again. Back, I think, was Lindelof.
Could be any better, could it? Whipped into that danger area, and it makes the striker's job so easy.
Oh, fuck off. It's five. It's fucking five. And De Gea's been absolute. He's been a shambles. I'm wondering if I should have started Henderson because he kept a clean sheet, but he kept a clean sheet against play young boys, so I don't know. Regardless, Henderson starting next game, whoever against. I think it's Watford. There's no way De Gea sees first team action for the next match after conceding five. Bruv, it's ridiculous. I can't get anything going. Can we get a goal, please? Just for morale. It's not even, my morale's not even there anymore. I can't even find a fucking pass to take a shot with anyone. Bruno, please. Oh, it's a wonderful finish, but it's going to mean jack shit all. I'm celebrating it like a bloody one. I don't give a shit, man. Bruno gets us one back, but it's realistically. We're celebrating it like we're back in a game. The United fans are like, what the fuck are they celebrating for?
Well, let's look at this again. The 1-2 touch passing is absolutely outstanding to play around the pressure. And then
it's a brilliant finish, but it's not going to matter.
The keeper has no time to react. It's a brilliant
Luke
strike.
Shaw's blocking. Oh, yeah, that's great. That's great. I don't know if it's deflected, and that's why it's fucked over Edison. It didn't look like it deflected. But one back. We've ruined our clean sheet. Slightly happier because of that fact. But they have scored five on us, and it is disappointing. Embarrassing. I'm really glad I didn't switch it. That's a good put a difficult up to legendary. Bloody glad I didn't.
Mahrez. That's not a bad ball.
Tellers might actually be one of the worst players to wear a United shirt. I'm not even saying that, like, I out of satire. I just genuinely don't think he's any good. Oh, fuck off, man. Rhythm, mate. I brought you on for a bit of pace and a bit of, you know, spark, a bit of chance creation. De Gea's got that, surely. Oh, you've punched it then, yeah? Why?
And you don't want to lose possession there. Making sure it didn't get past him. Not something you see terribly often. And offside here, Stuart.
Foden looking for his hat. Right, well, I think it was actually Bernardo who took the shot. Foden got in the way. And that's why it's been given us offside. I thought it was Foden going for his hat trick here. And he was complaining because he missed. Can we have this game wrapped up soon? 4 minutes, whatever. Referee. He's been a little prick.
Well, the referee not messing about. He's cautioned him.
I'll take whatever I can get against these guys now, obviously. Referee, that might even be grounds for a red. I mean, it isn't. I just want Foden off. I don't want to talk about this match. This is going to be a dark spot for this team. It'll only get better once we improve the team, though. Let's just have one from the GOAT himself. We've made it. I say we've made it look respectable. We haven't at all. We've been shit. They've just switched off because they know they've won, and we're taking a little bit of advantage of that. Ronaldo just absolutely blitzes through, finishes it off for another consolation. 7-goal thriller here at Old Trafford. Unfortunately, 5 of the goals have gone to Manchester City. I can't believe this behaviour from Manchester City, thinking they could just come here, rock up and destroy us. They've done exactly that. That's full time. Absolutely disappointing, absolutely embarrassing, quite frankly. We've got a couple of goals towards the end. Cyrus Amitai, absolutely devastated. We've lost against two of the biggest rivals already this season. Lost to City, lost to Liverpool. Diaz tried to console rhythm. But 5-2, lost to the neighbours. Looks five different scores as well. And the fun with the brace. Bernardo Silva, Riyad Mahrez and Gabriel Jesus for the visitors, with Fernandes and Ronaldo getting goals for us. And as much as I don't want to talk about that, we're going to have to here at the end. I just want to see this back, by the way. Goal of the season contender. Except it's the one goal that hasn't come up. Never mind then, we won't be looking at it with the goal of the season contender. But Phil Foden's definitely has to be up there. 56-44 in terms of possession, 16 shots to 9 in favour of Man City, 5.6 expected goals to 2.9 expected goals in favour of Man City as well. I mean, at the end of the day, it was deserved, so you can't really debate it, unfortunately. Let's take a look at the ratings then, see if anyone actually played somewhat remotely good. Ronaldo been given man of the match for us anyway, with a goal and a 7.6. Fred getting both the assists, he gets a 6.9. And then Bruno Fernandes with the other goal, 6.8 for him. Nobody really brilliant, to be honest. And I know I said Maguire was a better centre-back out of two, but they were both absolutely woeful today. And the fact that Lindelof's come on for Varane and played nearly as good as him, it shows how bad Varane really was that game as well. De Gea, 5.7. Telles with a 5.3. Rashford with a 5.3. I don't want to talk about it. We're not going into too much detail. Manchester City, though, man of the match, and you can't really deny it. It goes to Phil Foden, a full 10 rating. A brace up top for him. Bernardo Silva with an 8.4 and a goal. We have Mahrez with an 8.4 and a goal. Kevin De Bruyne from midfield, assisting twice, getting an 8.1. Gabriel Jesus with a goal and a 7.9. Rodri with a 7.6 and an assist. And then Grealish with the rest, the other assist. He gets a 6.6 because he came on late, but he got involved and we got battered. It's really worth restarting my, or having to restart my game 4 times because it kept crashing to do that episode, I'll tell you that much. Beautiful. At least the audio issues didn't persist.
Just a couple of questions
for you.
Most
disappointing press conference to do yet. This is more disappointing than Liverpool. Goes late goals, but a slow start. Already put the game out of reach. Yep, we were out. We're outdone. I'll try to give positive answers, but if a negative answer makes more sense, I'm giving it. You can't really take positives out of a 5-2 loss, can you? 5-2. Lads won't even tell them what went wrong. They know what went wrong. Defence, wank. Goalkeeping. De Gea is getting dropped for the next game. Foden is a fucking dangerous player. And I may poach him from City, honestly, when we can sign players just to be an asshole. He's an excellent player, but we did let him play. We opened up for his first goal. The fucking goal
Thank
of the season
contender.
Thank you for
your contender. Time. Really appreciate that. That's all the questions we have for you.
But Foden is definitely up there. One of the best young players in the game. Best young player in the Premier League by a country mile. And we dropped out 7th. We're making it difficult for ourselves here. I think at some point as well, Liverpool will probably overtake us. We're down in 8th now because everyone's played their 11th. And Liverpool are only 3 points off us. They were in relegation and we were top. Oh my. The drop-off has been astronomical. The only positive is we're still only about 3 points off top 4. And here's me thinking we might have an early challenge to win the league. Absolutely not. Absolutely not happening at all. We're just simming up to the next game. I believe it is Watford. We'll see in a second. Yep, it is. There you go. You can see it. Oh, boy. I don't really know what to say. I don't really know how to really justify myself there. We're against a relegation side, Watford, but in real life, we lost 4-1 to them, so I don't know, honestly. Let's take a look at the top four then. Wolves on 25 points. City on 22. Spurs on 22. Arsenal on 22. We're 3 points off the top four, but we also have an embarrassing goal difference. It's starting to get worse as well. We still scored the most in the Premier League, but I think we've now... There's only Southampton who have conceded the same as us, and Crystal Palace who have conceded more than us so far this season. It is a bit embarrassing. Brighton have done shit as well. Brighton, Watford and Southampton occupy the relegation zone. West Ham aren't up there like I thought they would be. Leeds are above us now, man. What the fuck? Take a look at the top scorers. Ben Yedder is clear now on 9. Ronaldo on 8 as well. See if anyone else, we've got anyone else in here. Fernandes and Donny on 5 apiece. And that's it for assists. Ronaldo, top assister as well. Fernandes on 5. Van de Beek on 4. Rashford on 3. And clean sheets. We've only got the one with Dav. He's been quite underwhelming in goal, to be honest. I press B, but I guess we're not going to register that. Alright, cool. So that wraps up quite an embarrassing and upsetting episode of the Manchester United career mode. I ain't happy about it, but we just have to pick ourselves up and move on to Watford. We're going to Vicarage Road and hopefully we can get 3 points. It'll be our first 3 points in the Premier League since the end of September. When was our last 3 points? It's been nearly 2 months since we won the Premier League. That's not top 4 form, is it, really? Aston Villa. It was literally nearly 2 months ago. We've won in the Champions League, but we drew 3-0 to Everton, 2-0 to Leicester, 2-1 to Liverpool, 1-0 to Spurs, and then a 5-2 loss to City. And we've had a 2-week break as well. And the problem is if we don't win here, the next Premier League match is Chelsea. So it's not going to be an easy one either. That'll be Monday's episode though, to be fair. For tomorrow's double upload, we've got Watford at Vicarage Road, followed by Villarreal at Old Trafford. Champions League is going to act as a bit of a break now because of the fact that we are already through I'll just show you the Champions League one before we get to that episode. I think we're actually already through top as well. I don't think there's actually a physical way that anyone could take first place from us either. Yeah, there's been a lot of bottling in our group. We've managed to stay strong and calm at the top of our group, and everyone else seems to be just losing points. Young Boys, I think, beat Villarreal. Villarreal beat Bergamo. Bergamo beat Young Boys. It's kind of a weird triangle down there. But we've just beaten everyone that put our path so far. Hopefully we can continue to do that and get the perfect 18 points. But realistically, the focus has to switch to the Premier League at some point because we need to get a win. And I think Watford might have to be just the ones that we make a statement against. But we'll see what happens next episode. I hope you guys have enjoyed this one. Before we do go, of course, as well, I'll save it over because the game does like to crash itself. It's poggers, isn't it, sometimes. But anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. If you're a City fan, you've absolutely loved it. If you're a United fan, you're embarrassed, and I'm embarrassed as well. I apologise for the loss, but it is what it is sometimes. We just get outclassed, and in the end, we got outclassed. But I hope you guys have enjoyed, regardless, and for the result, and I'll see you next time when we take on the Hornets.